Welcome to This is My Architecture. I'm Lana from AWS, and today we're talking to Sandeep from JD Power. Sandeep, welcome.
Thank you, Lana.
Great having you here. And would you mind telling us a little bit more about JD Power?
Yes, so JD Power is best known for our customer satisfaction research into new car purchases as well as their long-term reliability.
And today we're going to be talking about a data lake solution that you've built called AI Cloud. Mm-hmm. Would you mind explaining us a little bit more on how you're using that and how would a user interact with this system?
Sure. So before we talk about the solution, let me talk a little bit about the problem that we were trying to solve here. So at JD Power, every single year, we talk to hundreds of thousands of customers. We gather data from them, we create benchmarks and insights, and we publish rankings. So we work in several different industries, right? So it can be an automobile survey, or it can be a financial survey, or it can be a utility survey. So we do hundreds of different studies every year, and every single day we add a new survey.
And I'm seeing that we're starting with a web interface. So is this where we ingest data?
Yes, this is where we start by ingesting data, yes. So user basically logs into our web console here. And is authenticated using Cognito. So all the user information and authentication information is in Cognito. So once the user is logged into the console, you have access to a data ingestion module. So on the data ingestion module, you could create several connectors to all the different sources that we have at JD Power. The source can be a simple RDS instance, or it can be an S3 bucket, or it can be an FTP location, or it can be some kind of an API. Right? So once you create those connections, we use Glue to crawl through the data that is over there, and we create catalogs. And the catalog is saved in Glue. The data itself is moved to S3 buckets.
So we're using S3 as the centralized location where you can combine all of these data sources and have it available to run analytics, rich querying, and ETL workloads?
Yes, once the data is on the AI cloud, it's all in one place, S3 bucket.
Would you mind telling me a little bit more of how you're using Glue to create these catalogs?
Yes. So when you create the connector, Glue is our first line of defense where it goes and tries to crawl through those data sources and it tries to create a catalog. Now, most of the time, it does a very good job, but there might be some special files like an SPSS file or some internal special format files. So for that, we have our own crawlers. And those crawlers actually run on top of Fargate. So what happens is when user logs in, you have the ability to run a simple Lambda function, which uses Glue out of the box. And if Glue is not able to look at that file, create a catalog, then it moves on to the Fargate instance.
Okay, so here we have a shorter running jobs versus longer running processes that mm-hmm. do have some custom code that you're using to create a catalog. Mm-hmm. So let's say when we created this new catalog using your custom logic, does this get stored in a different location? Or is it imported back into Glue?
That's a very good question. So no matter if you use the Glue crawler or our custom crawlers, the catalog is only saved in Glue. So Glue is the only place where all the catalogs are saved.
Sounds great. And let's move on to Athena and Redshift. Mm-hmm. So how do you differentiate on what types of data do you use to query with Athena versus Redshift?
So most of our data analytical activity or data transformation activity happens on Athena. So even when we try to save the initial data onto S3, we convert that data into a Parquet format. Mm-hmm. It's a columnar format. Even that activity happens on top of Athena, right? Even once the data is saved in S3, all the transformations, all the cleaning rules happen on top of Athena. And we use Redshift when we try to expose the data to an analytical platform where you create dashboards.
Got
so
it.
That's where we use Redshift, and data moves from S3 bucket to Redshift in
so
that.
So creating a data warehouse here that is actually fed by the data lake itself.
Yes.
That sounds great. And as a data scientist, I would like to touch on how you're using machine learning and analytics dashboards to mm-hmm. make my job easier.
So we have a very large data science group at JD Power, and they all work on the AI Cloud platform. And we use Fargate to create either Jupyter Notebook or RStudio endpoints. They just log into the console where either the Jupyter Notebook or RStudio console is exposed, and they create all their models on top of that.
That sounds great. Sandeep, thank you so much for coming today and telling us a little bit more about JD Power and how you're using data lakes for your AI cloud solution.
Thank you, Lana.
And thank you for watching This is My Architecture.